Today on Wednesday Answers, I'm going to answer a question that I got last week, which basically was, where do I start if I want to get started with analog gear? So yeah, let me answer that. Now, the obvious first thing to talk about is, of course, which piece would you buy? And mainly, which piece would give the best bang for the buck? And yes, that is an interesting question, which I, of course, want to talk about more. But before I want to do that, I want to talk about this stuff here. Because if you've always worked in the box, before you can even use your analog gear, you first have to connect it, of course. And the goal is to connect it to your DAW. It's actually what I do as well. My whole studio is connected to my DAW. And the issue with, well, I think all good analog gear, is that it only has analog in and outputs. If you look closely, there's no USB on it. So what you need as well is an interface. Now, chances are you already have an interface. But that doesn't mean that you can connect the analog gear to your interface, because what you want to make is a loop. Connect an extra set of outputs and a set of inputs to your analog piece. And both the output and input have to be balanced audio. So that could be on XLR, which is this plug, or on jack, which are these ones. If you do not have an interface or want to switch interfaces because your interface is not capable, my recommendation is to look for an interface with either USB 3, Thunderbolt, or USB-C compatibility. What I've learned is that USB 2 really starts to get old and really cannot keep up anymore with the audio industry. And the USB 3, Thunderbolt, and USB-C ports offer, well, by definition, way lower latency than a USB 2 equivalent. Now, what you also have to think about is the size. Do you want to keep it small? Do you want to just have a stereo pair, like one compressor? Do you want to have multiple channels? Do you want to have scalability, as I call it? Or do you want to splurge a lot of money and like buy the biggest interface there is, with like, I think the biggest one that I know of is 64 channels, could that be? Because that is really important. I have a scalable setup consisting of multiple Motu AVB interfaces. But in general, this is really up to you. Now, when you have your interface, you also need the cables, of course, to connect to and from the analog piece. Let me turn it around. It looks better this way, I think. And honestly, I don't think it really matters what type of cable you use. I think that the most common brands, which cost around 1 to 2 euros per meter, are good enough for balanced audio. And I know that the hi-fi guys think different about this, but I'm also running pretty simple cable in my studio. I think I have a summer cable or something. But this really doesn't matter in audio quality. What does matter, not necessarily in audio quality, but more in longevity and in just the way it connects and works, are the connectors. And I really recommend going for either Neutrik or Amphenol. If you go with quality connectors, that really saves a lot of headaches. So now you can connect analog gear, but what gear are you going to connect? And that, yeah, that is a good question. Now, well, if it's your first piece of equipment, I certainly wouldn't recommend going with vintage gear. The problem with vintage gear is that you have to, well, know a lot about maintenance or have a guy that knows a lot about maintenance. And chances are that if you buy it, it doesn't work or needs maintenance or, you know, has noise in it or whatever. So I would really go for a new unit. You have warranty, and you can even, with like the better shops, you can send it back. So you can like kind of test it. Now, this unit, of course, is a very nice unit to start with. It's not very expensive. It sounds great. I did a review about it, which I will link in the corner. And the build quality is pretty good. I mean, look at this. I almost can't go wrong on this. Now, this thing, of course, is a compressor. I wouldn't say it's very well suited on the master bus. If you want to use something on the master bus, you might want to look at a Tegeler audio unit called the Cram. I, by the way, also reviewed that one. I'll link it over here. But that one is a little bit more expensive. Like this really is one of the only units that I know that is pretty good for starting with analog gear. A question that I find difficult to answer is analog EQing. I love analog EQing, but literally, I've just looked and I was a bit surprised by it as well. But all of my analog EQs are vintage. And when it comes to new analog EQs that, you know, fit a budget, I do not have a lot of knowledge. First thing that I would say, because of my experience with their products, would be like the Illusia stuff, the 500 series. And they even make a cube, which is really cool because this thing is pretty big. If you have a small studio, this could take up a lot of space on your desk or whatever. And like such a cube is a really small thing. It's actually aimed at that type of users. However, the prices go up pretty quickly from there. Like 19-inch units, good 19-inch units are really expensive when it comes to EQing. So that is a difficult one to answer. And I think that, you know, starting with compression is already a big step and is really something that could improve your sound and also could learn you more about analog gear. Now, what I want to warn you guys for is that working with analog gear is actually pretty... It's pretty addictive. So if you have one unit, it might be a big chance that you like it so much that you want to get more. So that is kind of a disclaimer, like you could get addicted to this pretty fast. As you can see from my studio. So yeah, that is my answer for today's video. Like, what do you need if you want to get started with analog gear? If you have a question that you want to see answered in such a video as this one, leave it in the comments below and I might answer your question in a future video. What I'm also going to do is link to Thomann below and make a list of analog starter gear, which would consist of both interfaces and some analog gear that I would recommend for starters. The disclaimer here is, of course, that I'm not being sponsored by any gear manufacturers at all, but I am affiliated with Thomann itself. So if you buy something at Thomann or Sweetwater, which is also linked below, a small amount gets kicked back to the studio and will help me create more time to make more videos. That's the basic thing going on. Now, if you want to support me in a different way, then it's possible by pledging a bit to my Patreon campaign, which I'm going to link over here. And on Patreon, you get early access to videos. There is a big Q&A that I'm doing every month. So a lot of good stuff over there. Last way to support me is, of course, by watching more videos. So don't forget to subscribe, like, and watch this video over here, if you haven't already, of course. Thanks a lot for watching. Keep pushing and bye-bye.